Are you curious about AI in Airtable? Well, as of September of 2025, Airtable's AI Labs has quietly released a new feature, allowing you to build your own data set from crawling the web using the web table component. In this video, I'm gonna show you how it works, and we're gonna walk through a live example. I'll tell you how many credits it uses, how long it takes, all of the details. So if learning more about this new AI web table feature is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission here to help you unlock the full potential of Airtable and related no-code tools. And in this video, I'm gonna be diving into Airtable's AI, the newest feature from their AI labs called Web Table. Now, as I mentioned at the top of this video, this is a new feature, so we're gonna be going step by step. It also takes a lot of time to complete, in north of 15 minutes to crawl the web and extract or scrape all the data we're looking for. So, in this video, I am gonna be doing a little bit of pausing, starting and stopping, so that you don't have to sit here and watch a screen tick by for 15 minutes. Now, before we get into the heart of the video itself, I first want to invite you to join me for some free training. We have put together an Airtable crash course that will teach you the foundational components of Airtable so that you can really start getting the most out of it. You can sign up for that crash course for free at gapconsulting.io/airtable-crash-course. And I will include links wherever you found this video. Once you sign up, we will be sending you bite-sized trainings over the course of about a week to help you master all of those core features of the software. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen. I've got a prompt ready to go. I'm gonna show you where it goes here in Airtable, and we are going to get the ball rolling on the AI labs here. So what we're gonna do, we are in a database already. I've got a few different tables built. The web table component, this AI feature, will build us a new table. So what we're gonna do is hit the plus here, and we are going down to the new table with web data. Now, if you don't see this feature already available, I will show you later in the video how to enable this. You have to go into your Airtable account settings and turn these different features on. I'm gonna show you exactly where that lives. So if you don't see it yet, bear with me. I'll get to that in a moment. But for now, I'm gonna select here. I'm gonna get this ball rolling. I've got a prompt already here, but I'm asking Airtable to find me a list of the best Airtable consultants to help me with a project. I want to include some elements like website, experience, contact, etc. Let's go ahead and send that out. And the first thing that's gonna happen is Airtable's gonna come back to us and say, okay, I've done a little bit of thinking on your request, and here's what I think you should be looking for. And so right here, you can see that I've got Airtable specialization, years of experience, contact, website, like a lot of information here. And some of this is what I asked for, and some of it is above and beyond. Now you also get a notice here on how much this is going to use your AI credits. So depending on your Airtable plan, you have a different number of Airtable credits for AI made available to you. Now, because this is in AI labs, which is the testing or the, you know, the cutting edge AI features, the cost is waived. But in the future, this would be a 42 credit cost. And also, it's going to give us that timing here. So as I mentioned, this is not an immediate thing. I'm going to say continue. It's going to go out and do all the looking and the scrolling and come back. We're going to come back later to see what it has compiled. And we're going to really cross our fingers that it's included us, Gap Consulting, in that list, because if it's not, then we did something very wrong from a search perspective. So, fingers crossed that we are not excluded from the AI labs, and that's gonna be wildly embarrassing if we're not in that list. So let's go ahead now and take a look at how we get those settings turned on. Then I'm gonna pause the video so that you don't have to sit and watch the wheels turn behind the scenes, and I'll come back at the end when this has been fully generated. So let's go ahead and dive into how we toggle this on. So let's flip into our real like Airtable account itself, and it depends on what type of plan you are on, where you will see or find the settings for AI Labs. So if you are on a Teams plan or lower, you're gonna find AI Labs in the settings of your workspace. So let's look at Gap Consulting 1.0. This is an old plan that is on the Teams plan, and we will want to go to the workspace settings for this workspace. Now, inside of here, we can scroll down. We're gonna take a minute to load. And by the way, this is where you will find the number of automations, the number of attachments, the number of records per base, and most importantly for our video here, the number of credits that you've used for Airtable AI. So bear in mind, you get a certain number of credits per user on your workspace. So I guess the math for this team plan works out so that we have 116,000 credits and we've used 57. So we got a ways to go. But what I want to bring your attention to is the AI Labs. These are the new features that Airtable is kind of beta testing within its AI components. You have to toggle this on, and you also have to have toggled on Airtable AI for your workspace. So if you don't have these things on, then of course you're not going to get access to the cutting edge AI features that are available in AI Labs. Now, the other place to do this is for the Teams plans and below. If you are on a business or better plan, the enterprise scale plan, there's a different place. So what that looks like, you're gonna need to go to your admin panel. And this is again for those more advanced plans. Here you're gonna need to go to settings, and then from here, find your AI settings tab. Tab over to that, and you need to enable Airtable AI from here, and then also get the early access to new AI features. Now, bear in mind that this particular feature is also crawling the internet, so you're gonna probably need to have that internet access turned on as well, because this new feature, as I said, is going out there, it's crawling the internet, it's finding the relevant data that we requested and bringing it back. So use this feature knowingly and make sure you have the right settings toggled on for your account. I should mention, you have to be an admin user in your Airtable account that includes for the business or the enterprise scale plans. If you're not an admin user with admin access to the admin panel, then you need to get a hold of somebody who is that can turn on these settings. So that's it for getting all of this turned on. Let's go ahead and pause here. We'll come back when our query is done and AI has completed the scraping of data. We'll see what it compiles for us in a minute. All right, so our web table is now created, but I do want to highlight that you don't exactly see a new table in the setup that we were working on. So let's talk about time frame and you know, how long did it take to get this done? What was the actual output? I'll show you exactly where to find all of this information. Now, first, I want to call out that it did take about 15 minutes. So the estimated time on the AI generated tab from the get-go was fairly accurate. Now, in order to access the output, what we need to do is actually do a little bit of hunting, because I did not keep my page untouched. And I got distracted, I started doing something else, and that kind of put this AI generated thing on the back end. So now we have to go look for it, and I'll show you where to find it. So the first thing we need to do is open Omni back up. And by default, we're gonna be in a new Omni chat. So what we actually need to do is pull ourselves out and go back to the chat prompt that we set up for this. And so right here, you can see that we actually had this chat prompt. It was the most recent one. And here are the different consultants that were pulled. And thankfully, we are on this list somewhere. At least I am personally called out. It didn't say Gap Consulting, but let's actually put this into effect and see what's going on. So we can save it to our base, or we can just expand this and take a full look at this list. So right here, we can see all of the different folks who are called out, and thankfully, This was a true test here. We are on the list, which is great. It's actually pretty extensive. It gave me a much longer list than I expected. This gave us 75 different consultants. Some of these I'm actually very familiar with and I know personally, and some of them not so much. Of course, that doesn't mean that they are not very great consultants. It's just that I haven't had the pleasure yet. But let's go ahead and see what our other options are here. So we can download this as a CSV. We can copy it to a clipboard, or we can save it to a base. I want to just save it right to the base and bring this information right into it. But I do want to also see what else is going on here in terms of what it's found for us. Looks like it's scraping contact information. It has, for us anyway, info@gapconsulting.com. This is a valid email address, so I can speak to this. I'm glad that it found that. In terms of the service offerings, it says no code solutions, consulting, custom automation courses, educational content on Airtable. So this is pretty accurate. I mean, these are, one way of describing the different services we have. I'm, of course, using us as an example here because I think that I can speak directly to the relevance of the data. In terms of years of experience, this says 7 years. We came into effect in 2018, which this recording is 2025, so that is accurate. In terms of client testimonials, I don't think that this is actually valid. These client testimonials, this is not our website, so this part is not 100% valid. This is our active website. I wish that it would bring in the entity name as Gap Consulting, not my name as the founder, but, okay, it's not perfect. And then also, of course, we see services offered. So we can see here that I'm a no-code consultant offering Airtable consulting, and here it's calling out my firm Gap Consulting. Again, I wish that this was brought in at the entity name, but maybe our prompt wasn't quite good enough to get that data. It doesn't have any information about our certifications, and it does call out our YouTube channel, which is nice. So, okay, this is a pretty good data set. It's not 100% perfect, obviously, but for a data scrape, what did that cost us to get? I mean, that's pretty impressive, right? So let's now save it to the base. I'm gonna save it as a new table, and it should be that simple. I've just said save as a new table. We see that it is creating consultants as a new table with the 7 fields. Let's now pop out of the chat here and go into our base itself. So I'll close down Omni. Here's that new table, 75 records, all scraped from the internet using the new web table. So I am assuming that this is public information and that this information has been put out there and therefore Airtable has access to it, or Airtable's AI, which of course they have in partnership with ChatGPT. Now, do bear in mind that I was able to build this at the data layer. I have not experimented with it in interfaces yet. I imagine that if we were in the interfaces, we might not get the same level of access that we do at the build level. I tend to prefer to do things at the data layer unless they are interface specific. So bear that in mind when you're putting this together yourself. But thoughts moving forward, where do we go from here? Well, this is a really powerful feature allowing you to cultivate some data scraping directly into your Airtable databases. Let's make sure that we're using this kind of power for good and not spamming people, because God knows I get enough spam emails already. So let's hope that people do actually use this ethically moving forward. I also want to call out that I don't know how it has prioritized these folks. What I'm seeing at the top of this list is maybe some of the not most well-known consulting firms. I actually find some of the better-known consulting firms further down the list, which I find interesting, like Rudd Consulting, Optimize.io. There are also some people that I think are definitely missing from this list, so I don't think it's necessarily extensive, but, oh, and look at this. Sure enough, Gap Consulting is actually another line item on this list. So, it's not perfect, folks, but it's a great starting point, right? I mean, scraped data, and in this case, free data that we're not paying for because it's still in AI labs, that's pretty awesome stuff. So use this feature, tell me what you think about it, drop your ideas or thoughts in the comments below. Of course, if you got value from the video, we'd love a thumbs up. Subscribe to the channel if you love this content. And if you have questions that we didn't get to answer here, swing by our website because we've put a ton of resources available for you there to check out. But of course, most importantly, my friend, keep on building.